This EVMS training snippet, sponsored by the U.S. Department of Energy's Office of Project Management, discusses the process and results associated with periodic and comprehensive EACs. The purpose is to provide a common understanding within DOE and among DOE contractors, and to provide consistency in understanding the differences and similarities in conducting a periodic or monthly EAC versus a comprehensive or bottom-up EAC. The estimate at completion, or EAC, is a crucial part of the project management plan. A properly established and maintained EAC ensures continuing visibility into the cost, schedule, risks, and opportunities, and resource requirements to complete the project. This process provides insight into future project resource requirements and for future funding needs, a concern of the DOE Federal Project Director. The basic formula for any EAC is the actual costs of the work performed, or ACWP, or the past plus the estimated cost to complete the remaining work scope, or the future. This is also called the estimate to complete, or ETC. In other words, the EAC represents the total project cost for all authorized work scope. Work that is anticipated or not yet on contract is not included in the contract EAC, but should be in the FPD's EAC. An accurate and current EAC supports DOE's ability to monitor project funding. However, the contractor EACs are not constrained by the availability of funding or the negotiated contract costs. This graph demonstrates the relationship between the actual costs on a project to the estimate at completion. The difference between these two data elements is the estimate to complete, or ETC. As seen here, the forecasted time span associated with the ETC is the same as the estimated completion date. This estimated completion date matches the schedule's forecasted completion date for the project. As mentioned, the essential formula for all EACs is the cumulative actual costs on a project, plus the estimate to complete the remaining work. The actual costs of work performed is simply an export from the earned value tool. So the more difficult part of developing an EAC is creating the estimate to complete, which is the cost required to complete the remaining authorized project work scope. In an EVMS, the budgeted cost of the work remaining, or BCWR, is calculated as the budget at completion less the cumulative earned value, or BCWP. This formula will provide the budgeted value of that remaining work. Next, we can focus on the actual costs required to complete the BCWR. Shown graphically, we can see the relationship between the budget at completion, or BAC, and the budgeted cost of work performed, or BCWP. The difference between these two elements is the budgeted cost of work remaining, or BCWR. The estimate to complete the remaining work scope is developed at the element of cost level, meaning labor, material, subcontracts, other direct costs, etc. This is done at the work package, planning package, and summary level planning package levels. This estimate is based on the available time-phased resources and must correspond to the dates in the forecasted schedule. In other words, the time-phased ETC must correspond to the time phasing of the forecasted work scope. Putting these concepts together, the ETC is the difference between the EAC and the cumulative ACWP. This value represents the forecasted cost to complete the work remaining on the project, and the budget value of that work is calculated by subtracting the cumulative BCWP from the BAC. Now that we have covered the formulas and graphical representations of the EAC, let's turn our attention to the process. On a monthly basis, one of the roles of the Control Account Manager, or CAM, is to review the EACs of their control accounts for relevance and currency. The contractor may establish thresholds for an EAC review at the control account level, and while exceeding this threshold may be a good indicator that an EAC should be evaluated, it does not necessarily mean that an EAC must be changed. In addition, not exceeding a threshold does not necessarily mean that the EAC for a control account should not be reviewed for realism. The CAM knows the day-to-day issues and is in the best position to identify non-recurring cost impacts and those that are recurring. This information assists the CAM in determining if the EAC needs to be updated, and if so, by how much. The primary driver for changing the forecast of costs is realization that the current ETC is no longer realistic, nor is consistent with the remaining work. There are many drivers which may cause a need to change the EAC, but schedule delays, cumulative cost variances, changes in performance, technical performance issues, and realized risks are among them. Often, a look back at past performance can provide insight into future performance. This method also provides a means of checking the realism of the EAC. This can be done by comparing the Cost Performance Index, or CPI, to the To Complete Performance Index, or TCPI, to provide the reasonableness of the EAC. The formula for reviewing the past is by using the CPI, which is determined by dividing the BCWP by the ACWP. The formula for the TCPI uses the previous formulas we discussed. The numerator is the BCWR, while the denominator is the ETC. In this way, the future is predicted. The CPI is a measure of cost efficiency on completed work, while the TCPI is a measure of cost efficiency required on non-completed work in order to achieve the EAC. Again, a significant difference between these two indices does not necessarily mean that an EAC is incorrect and must be changed, nor is the lack of difference a sure sign that the EAC remains valid. However, a difference is an indication that an EAC should be reviewed for realism. If despite the difference the decision is made to not update the EAC, then a logical and valid justification should be documented. Simply stating that there will be future efficiencies or that performance will improve is insufficient justification. This graph demonstrates the relationship and difference between the two indices. The CPI is a measure of cost efficiency to date on the project, or whatever level of the project this measure is run. The TCPI is a forward-looking index that measures the efficiency required to achieve the EAC. The Integrated Project Management Report, or IPMR, requires the reporting of the project manager's best case, worst case, and most likely EACs. These will differ from the summation of the CAM EACs. The process and reasonings for the difference are explained in Snippet 5-5, IPMR Purpose and Use. In addition to reviewing the EAC on a monthly basis to verify that it is consistent with current performance and conditions, it is required that a periodic comprehensive or bottom-up EAC assessment of the entire project work scope is conducted. These updates are required at least annually on projects, but more often if either contractual or performance conditions warrant it. In preparation for the comprehensive EAC, the project will establish ground rules and assumptions for the exercise, including subcontractor participation, an overall timeline for completion, and incorporation into customer reporting. This process typically starts with the control account managers and often involves the IPT leads, functional managers, the project manager, and senior executives. Comprehensive EACs are different than the monthly updates in that they require a greater degree of formality and examination. This includes an evaluation of remaining project-level existent and emerging risks and/or opportunities, a review and incorporation of the latest direct and indirect rates, an assessment of any environmental changes that may impact future schedule and costs, CAM-level assessment and incorporation of subcontractor EACs, incorporation of commodity increases or decreases, and a review of all remaining work scope, including the scope residing in the undistributed budget and authorized unpriced work. In summary, a current, accurate, and complete estimate at completion is a crucial component of project management. DOE depends on its accuracy to manage funding. The EAC is calculated by adding the actual costs incurred to date on the project plus the forecast of cost, or ETC, to complete the remaining work scope. The CAMs on the project are required to review the EACs for their control accounts on a monthly basis for relevance and currency. The primary driver for changing the forecast of costs is realization that the current ETC is no longer realistic and a comparison between the CPI and the TCPI can be a quick and easy reality check of the EAC. In addition to monthly updates, a comprehensive or bottom-up EAC update is a formal process involving the entire project management team and is required at least annually. For additional information relative to EVMS procedures, templates, helpful references, more snippets, and training materials, please refer to DOE PM's external EVM homepage or the internal max.gov PM library. Check back periodically for updated or new information. Thank you for using the Snippet library.